The ADOT Enforcement and Compliance Division has implemented technology into this rest area so that we can monitor and screen commercial vehicles, especially the intrastate drivers. In the past, we have had to haul our scales around, set up all this equipment. Now we're going to be able to just plug into the system. There's a weigh in motion out there. It's going to weigh the truck. The DOT reader is going to read the TOT number on the truck and then the plate number as well. It's going to pop up on a computer screen. It's going to let us know if there's an alert or a safety issue where the truck needs to be looked at. And then with the message board, we'll be able to pull that truck in off of the interstate to screen more closely. When they enter the rest area, we have static scales that are already placed in ground. We will get an accurate weight and see if there's any action that needs to be taken, and then we can go from there.
The primary focus is to use the technology on commercial vehicles to determine the approximate weight, registration, permit, and also the records will give us the safety standards that are on file. Trucks that are overweight will do more damage to the pavement surface. We make sure that they're properly permitted and that they pay the appropriate user highway fees, which are used to do the maintenance and repair of the roadway surface.
The technology is going to be put in place at three locations, I-19 at the Canoa rest area, the Sacaton rest area on I-10, and then it'll be here at McGuireville on I-17. Those locations were picked because of the high volume of truck traffic that comes through the area.
ADOT wants to make it clear that the cameras are not tied to any type of speed measurement. They cannot determine any speed of vehicle, and it will not be used in any other function other than for the commercial vehicle inspection.
Just going to do a level 2 inspection on you, check your paperwork, check out the truck real quick.
The system is not only going to benefit us, it's going to benefit the motorists, it's going to benefit the trucking companies, because by screening these vehicles as they come through, we're going to be able to sort out the vehicles that are in compliance and let them continue down the highway, and then the ones that are questionable, we're going to bring in and we're going to take a closer look at them.